Have you been in the following situation? You have a blissful sleep and then the alarm starts beeping. Why is that? What is going on? You smash the damn thing. It takes you a second, but you're late for work! Then you rush with the hope you'll get away with it. If you haven't, then you have the chance to experience it in Level 22 Garry's Misadventure. I essentially summarize the plot. You play as Garry, who constantly is late for work. He has his last warning. If he is late one more time, he is fired. But Garry is a carefree guy, and of course, he slept over right after a heavy night celebrating his birthday. However, upon reaching the building he works, he needs the guidance of his friend Marty, who is a master of slacking without getting caught. He used to work there, but he quit. He is the tutorial throughout the whole game. When he sees some new obstacle, he immediately calls you to help you deal with it. However, you have to figure out the bosses. The plot is quirky and the whole situation is relatable but exaggerated multiple times. What helps is the character movement, expressions and the detail put in every single section. All this leads to the gameplay. Level 22 is an office stealth slash puzzle game. The goal is to use every available item to sneak past the NPCs. Some have a movement pattern you need to observe, others are stationary. Some are easily deceived, others take more elaborate ways to get passed by. The way NPCs work is quite simple. They have a cone vision and it's split in two in the middle. From the upper half, the wider area, they don't detect you immediately, giving you a chance to get out of the cone vision area. However, if you are in the narrow area, you are fired on the spot. Game over. You are thought early on you can just walk past their field of view. I quite like how the stealth is set up. It's giving you a good margin for mistakes. It's less strict by not giving you immediate game over. Also, you can abuse their field of view. This is not how you are actually supposed to do this section, but it's doable. And even if you are caught, restarting is fast and fluid, just a click away. Thanks to the generous checkpoint system, you won't be set far back. There is a consistent flow of new ways to deceive the enemies. You start with a simple one, a newspaper. If an NPC is walking, you just need to open it and he'll ignore you. However, you are stuck in one place. Another two is the cardboard box. It's almost the same as the newspaper, but with the difference that you can move, albeit slower than usual. I like that for the design of all the tools, the dev used everyday items. Nothing feels out of the ordinary and fits the office setting. Well, besides the lightsaber. He is underutilized, but it fits the setting. You can use it against robots designed to replace people in the office. Don't ask. The other two you can use are coffee, slingshot made from office supplies, and even laxative is used to your advantage. One of the simplest ways to avoid enemies is to hide in a trunk or a cabinet. Regular enemies are easily deceived with a newspaper or cardboard box, but there is a different type of NPCs, like a security guard that can see through your disguise, so you need to find another way to sneak past him. The level design complements well the gameplay. It's mostly a variety of offices, but there is also a lab, parking, storage, etc. I found some frustration in them. They are all created in a very colorful and vibrant, gorgeous pixel art filled with character, but the view sometimes gets in your way. In some places, you can't be sure if an NPC will see you because visually it's hard to know where your cover ends. The worst case I came across was a newspaper that was difficult to notice. Now, those are minor issues. They're not present all the time to ruin the game, but it's worth mentioning them. There is a nice variety of NPCs, tools, and situations you have to overcome. However, the puzzles are not challenging enough. That's my biggest gripe. Here's what I mean. Now, levels are relatively short and small in size. You can finish one in 10-15 minutes on a first playthrough. The game could benefit from wider levels, especially by the end. In games, you gradually are presented with new challenges or mechanics. That is somewhat the same here. Then you expect by the end all you have learned to be put to the test. However, that's not the case here. On one level, you are presented only with part of the things you learn. On the next other, there isn't a single level that put everything to test you. It's lacking that gradual escalation in difficulty. Don't get me wrong, the game is still fun, but instead of being great, it's just good, and that's a bit disappointing. I've seen people complain the game doesn't detect their Xbox controller. It worked flawlessly for me, just plug and play. Controls are responsive and I didn't have any issues with them. I haven't tried using mouse and keyboard, but the controller feels more natural for this type of game. There was one more interesting thing that surrounds the game. The game you're seeing is a re-release. From what I've managed to find, the original developer went bankrupt and the game was given to a new developer that improved on the game. One example is the camera. With the left thumbstick, you can now look ahead, which was not possible in the original version. Also, the publisher claims tweaks are made to feel less like a puzzle game, whatever that means. The improvement of the camera is a welcome change. It helps a lot when planning where to go, how to approach the moment-to-moment gameplay and avoid enemies. Would I recommend the game? Yes, even at full price. There are enough reasons to do it. The game is brimming with charm and quirkiness. The gameplay is solid. The music is great. The length is good for what it offers, between 3 and 4 hours. It has surprisingly good boss battles. Well, they are 50-50 for me, but still enjoyable. The art style is so good. I love the big blocky heads of everyone, and everything is so colorful, and along with the levels, everything is designed with sense and style. The game might drop the ball in the gameplay department a bit, but it's still fun time. If you want to be challenged, try to find all the codes for the safe. You can see them in the environment and not easy to decipher, and all the hidden toys. I went for some of them. I did 100% the game. All that's left to say is, it's worth a B.